大家好，朋友们，
同学们，大家好。
You mentioned that within this class we are going to study how we say addresses in Chinese.
Yes. In this class, it's about the word order of address. So address in Chinese, it means 地址 and 地 it means the land or the ground, and 址 it means the location. Let's get started.Address in Chinese is written as follows. It starts with the biggest geographical component and ends with the smallest. What that means? So, for example, we will write the biggest geographical, for example, country first, and then we will write province, and then it's the city, and then it's road, and then it's the road number or thehome number, and then is the postcode. For example, country is 中国 China. Province is 广东省 It means 广东 province. City, 广州市 It means 广州 city. Road is 花园路 It means the garden, the road of garden, or the garden road, or theand this road number is 102 or 102号, it means 102. And the last case is the postcode. For example, 51000, it's like 510000. So this structure is a basic Chinese word order.Of address. You need to remember that the word order of Chinese addresses goes from big to small.
In general, I have noticed that in the Chinese language, we always go from big to small.
Yes, from big to small.
Mm-hmm.
It's exactly the opposite of English. It's opposite. For example, in some Western countries, we will start from the smallest and to the biggest. But in Chinese,We will start from the biggest to the smallest.
Okay, clear. Thank you. And maybe more examples from workbook. In the workbook, page 46, we have exercise 5. And in this exercise, we need to put words in the correct order. So we have 1319号房间。Like room number 1319, 23, number 23, I suppose the building number, 大学路 street 大学大学生公寓 students let's say residence. So in this case, students residence is bigger. That's why we say 大学生公寓。Mm-hmm. And then street, 大学路, and then building number. In this case, we say 二三号, 对吗?
二三号 or 二十三号. If the number is less than 100, we will just pronounce this 23, 二十三. But if more than 100,
okay, thank you.
We will just pronounce the numbers independently.
And then...room number or flat number is apartment number, sorry. It's, we say in the end, 1319号房间.
Yes, but mm-hmm. I think you have one mistake is that 大学路 is a road, it's a street. So I think 路 is bigger than the 大学生公寓。So it means the 公寓 is located in the road, in the street. So street has so many different buildings. But 大学生公寓 it means the dormitory for the students. So it's one of the buildings in this street. Clear? So we will put 大学路 at first, and then 大学生公寓, and then the building number.23号 and the last one is the room number 1319.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. And number two, we have Gongyuan Street, Beijing, 26 number, and then Zhongguo. Mm-hmm. And clear, in this case, we say Zhongguo, then Beijing, then Gongyuan Lu, and then the building number, 26号.
Yes, absolutely. So next one.
Number three, we have building number 75. Then Xin Shanghai Gongyu residence, which is called New Shanghai, and then Shanghai Lu, Shanghai Street.
Mm-hmm.
So in this case, again, we say Shanghai Street, building number, and then residence name Shanghai Lu, 75号, Xin Shanghai Gong.
Yes, yes, absolutely. So the first is the Shanghai Lu, is a street, and then the Xin Shanghai Gongyu is the buildings and the buildings number 75号. So it will be Shanghai Lu, Xin Shanghai Gongyu, 75号.
I see. Thank you. And then the number four is very easy. Beijing Lu, 38号.
Right, that's right.
Mm-hmm. And number five is we have street number, street residence name, and then number. So we say 大学路, London Gongyu, 15号.
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. And number six, we clear, we have two, and it's very easy. 新大学生公寓 709号 房间.
Mm-hmm. Yes. 新大学生公寓 709号 房间. So it's the first case, it's a dormitory, and then it's the room number.
Thank you. Kayan, everything super clear. It seems like easy, but still can confuse the word order in the Chinese language, because like it's different to the English language. And could you tell us which topic are we going to discuss in the next video?
So in the next class, we are going to talk about the initials of Chinese word. So it's actually a part of pinyin, and we will explain all the initials.
Mm-hmm. So initials means the first letter of the word, am I right?
The first letter of the pinyin.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. Guys, do not afraid of the word initials. Like, we'll explain everything in the next class. 谢谢,再见.
Okay, 同学们再见. Mm-hmm.